The only time I or my girlfriends are actively seeking male attention while on motorcycles is during street vibrations in Reno, Nevada. And honestly, we don't even want your attention. We just want your Mardi Gras beads. Welcome, everyone, to the House of Sovereign. This is my second channel. Click the link above to find my main channel, where we are 10,000 subscribers away from that 100K plaque. And hello to all of my IRL friends that may be watching this video. It is a rare thing for me to do a sit-down video over here on this channel, but it's something that I'm thinking I'm gonna do more frequently. As a female motorcyclist, I have a unique perspective. I get the thrill of experiencing the world through the lens of a rider and the annoyances of experiencing riding as a woman. I came across this post recently on an app designed specifically for motorcyclists. Let me read this to you. Some ladies' accounts on Tonet be like, "Two-wheeled Tuesdays, boys and girls. I'm serious about motorcycles. Really. Love 'em. Whispers it's a trap. Hey, my eyes are up here." I love how they put "ladies" in quotation marks, as if to imply that the women somehow aren't. It's been a while since I've seen this level of condescension come from a man. So imagine my surprise when I realized that it was in fact a woman who posted this. Oh yes, ladies and gentlemen, we have a mouthy motorcycle Mary on our hands. And before I dive into this, before I really just dig in here, I want to be 100% transparent, okay? I seek no beef with this woman. I seek no problems. I'm not even wearing the crown of shade. Those of you who know my main channel, you know what the crown of shade is. I'm not even trying to throw shade. I'm not trying to throw beef, even though I sure as hell will eat it. I am not attempting to start a war as of yet. I am saying this because the woman who posted this resides here on the platform. She has somewhat of a YouTube channel herself. I do not want her to hate me, though if she chooses to do so for me calling out this pick-me-ass behavior, then I will surely find a way to go on. Yes, this is an example of a pick-me, defined as a girl who goes out of their way to impress boys and make them seem that they are not like other girls, kind of like a simp, but for girls. She usually does this to be accepted by the boys and be considered one of the good ones. You know, the "I'm not like other girls" chick. Let me break this down. This post implies that because the woman in the photo decided to wear a tank top, she is subtly attempting to catfish the attention of men whilst pretending to be a serious motorcyclist, which of course she isn't because of the way that she's dressed. In this heat of peak riding season, I feel I should let the biker boys and community know that women are not only hot, but can in fact feel warm temperatures as well. During these times, the human female will begin to shed her winter layers, therefore showing more of her natural anatomy. Contrary to popular belief, this is not a mating call nor a signal to males, but a natural attempt at cooling an overheated core and/or avoiding boob sweat. The fact that we look hot in an attempt not to be hot is an ironic, mostly unfortunate circumstance. This pick-me wanted to publicly mean girl snicker at a woman who simply chose to wear a tank top. And I'm not saying this simply because of this one post. I think many women can speak to a circumstance during the hot summer months where you have been chastised because of your wardrobe choices whilst on a bike. And this conversation is long overdue. Most of us have seen the bikers, have the biker friends, those guys that ride their motorcycle any which way they so choose, shirtless, in flip-flops, with a Speedo on. Men can do whatever the hell they want on their bikes, and no one's going to accuse a man of seeking female attention because he decided to wear a wife beater, a tank top, a t-shirt, some shorts. But the moment I decide to wear a tank top, I'm punished because of my natural female anatomy, as if we don't get hot, as if we are impervious to the sun. Like,
I want to take all my clothes off and ride in my boxers. I tell you right now, I apologize, all you squids. I feel your pain now, because as you see right now, I don't care. I get skinned up. It is hot. It is too hot to be wearing full leathers in here smoke all the time. Maybe at nighttime. In the daytime, oh my goodness. I was cooking.
Can we please dismantle the idea that every action a woman takes is for the pleasure of men? Please. I hear it oh so too often, especially on the YouTube platform. I hear it from too many people. Everything women do is for men. I get my nails done, is for men. I do my makeup, is for men. I got a cute outfit on, is for men. And we can't so much as wear a t-shirt on our bikes without it being for men. Let me just let you guys know, okay? It's not that hard. If I want a biker boy's attention, like men, even you can attest to this, right? It's not that hard to get the attention of men, specifically biker boys. Like all you have to do is, I don't know, compliment his aftermarket exhaust, ask to see a wheelie. Just tell him his bike is nice. We don't have to work that hard. I don't have to put on a whole wardrobe change to get a guy to look at me. And by the way, I'm calling BS on everybody, including this girl, because she tried it too, on everybody who's trying to make this about gear and safety and all that, regardless of how you may feel on the subject of squidding or having all your gear together and everything, that was not the purpose of this post. Though in the comment section, this girl surely did try to backtrack when I called her on this BS. She's like, well, I just, you know, road rash is a terrible thing and I would hate to see those Hooters all scratched up. That wasn't the purpose of this post. The purpose of this post was to shame women on their wardrobe choices and also display the fact that you consider yourself not like other girls. You're so much like outside of the whatever. Like that was the purpose of this post. And I said it publicly. So anybody in the comment section is like, oh, you should have told her. I sure as hell, I told her. I did say so in the comment section before she deleted the post. I did. The fact of the matter is, it's not my fault. It probably is a little bit my fault because I do go to the gym, but my naturally curvaceous figure and impeccable fashion sense does not dictate what I wear or if I'm doing it for men. Like that's not something that I have, like I'm changing on purpose. That's part of who I am as a person. I wear all types of stuff on my motorcycle that people have told me they consider sexy, right? Sometimes I will wear shorts on my bike. And if I'm just staying in town, that doesn't bother me so much. And you know what? It's my decision. If it's 110 degrees outside and I wanna wear shorts, that's on me. That's my decision, but it's not for looks. It's because my butt cheeks are sweaty. Sometimes I wear shorts, likely with my thigh-high leather boots so that I have more protection over my legs. I don't have pebbles flying in my legs. I'm not getting burned. I'm not getting scuffed up. God forbid somebody like scuff me or I do trip or something. I have more protection. I understand that to the male gaze, that looks like an outfit choice that I chose for sex appeal, but it's not. I just happen to have nice boots and nice thighs, but it wasn't for you. It's to get ventilation to the cheeks. I wear full gym body suits that have like a full back out and everything. I know the outfit looks sexy, but actually it's meant for the gym. I wear it on my bike because it's comfortable, it's good with sweat, and it's aerodynamic. A lot of people think it's just a sexy option. I cannot help that my clothes and my selection of clothing happens to be hot and I look good in it. That does not mean, you see what I'm getting at here? Everything that I do, regardless of if it comes off as sexy, is not necessarily meant to be for said purpose. Understand, no matter what I choose to wear, I'm probably gonna look damn good in it. And so what if I happen to do it on my motorcycle? There have been times I wore two-piece outfits on my motorcycle because I was on my way to the gym. I may have looked good on my bike, but I was purposefully going to the gym and it was damn hot outside. Once again, please dismantle the thought process in everybody's mind that everything women do is for guys, okay? Like honestly, it's very laughable. And I know all men do not think this way. This post specifically was posted by a woman, which is why I'm like losing my brain over it. Cause it's like, girl, do you have no friends? Clearly you don't. Like this is clearly a woman that doesn't have any girlfriends because this pick me ass behavior says I hang around nothing but boys, okay? Because every girl knows the sexiest outfits that we wear in front of our girlfriends. The sexiest, hottest shit that I have in my closet, I wear to ladies' night. I have BDSM outfits. I got the fishnets. I got the leather. We do all that stuff during ladies' night. I don't wear it for you guys. I wear it for the girls. The pick me doesn't understand that because clearly she doesn't have any female friends. Girl, you need to get yourself some friends so you learn. This behavior is not acceptable. Putting down women and disseminating this type of false misogyny is not acceptable. And men, I appreciate you, okay? Because I know, like, this post is not even on you guys. And there are some men that behave this way, but I do want to give props and accolades and applause to men who know better than to chastise biker girls on what we choose to wear. I have a ton of motorcycle guy friends, and never, not one of them have ever said anything about what I wear, unless it's just saying, hey, you look good or you look nice. They would never chastise me on the decision. Do they sometimes get distracted by the overall look of the outfit? Absolutely. But they would never put me down for it. And most of the time they understand that if I'm wearing, you know, shorts and my leather boots, it's because it's hot. If I'm, you know, if I don't have my giant leather jacket on, it's because it's hot. If my friend Margaret or even Amber's wearing a crop top, which I wish Amber would wear a crop top. Amber, put on a crop top for me. Look, if she's wearing certain things, or if Bree's wearing certain things, or if Izzy's wearing something, like, no one's coming at them, because the guys in our group or my guy friends understand girls get hot too. And they understand that it's not for them specifically, and it's completely permissible to take undercover enjoyment and the summer looks of the girls. I'm not gonna say I don't do the same thing. Look, I hit on my girlfriends all the time. They know it's the thing that we do. But even when, you know, men come into the gym looking scrumptious, I know they're not wearing their tank top and shorts for me. They're not doing their bench press specifically for my attention, but that doesn't mean I'm not gonna like it. Doesn't mean I'm not gonna peek. I'm surely gonna peek, but I understand that the purposes of what they're doing is not just to catch the females in the gym. Like I said, guys, nobody has to work that hard. Just come give me your number, it's cool. All I'm asking in this video from men and women is to let us live. Let us live in peace, okay? Believe it or not, some women are just naturally sexy. They are. I mean, some women truly just like wake up like that. Everything they put on is sexy. They could just wear like an oversized t-shirt, they're still sexy. Anything they wear on their bike, full winter gear, they just be sexy. Like, some women are just naturally like that. And they shouldn't have to be made to feel insecure about what other people are going to think about them, when all they're looking for is some simple damn comfort and relief from the heat. Yes, I and other women are well aware that we look fucking great on our bikes, all right? We like looking at ourselves in the windows of passing cars and businesses as much as guys like looking at themselves in the windows of businesses and thinking you look cool in all your riding gear, which you do, babe. Okay, you biker boy, look. You do. I'm gonna say you do. Like, but we like looking good the same way men like looking good, okay? Yes, when I have like my leggings on and I got a t-shirt, I feel like I look badass and I love it. But it's not for anyone other than myself. And women should not be made to feel any more uncomfortable than men do simply getting to ride around in their t-shirts and whatnot. And once again, men, I know that a lot of you don't do this and you know better, because if you chastise women on what they wear, they might stop wearing it, and then there goes your, like, your subtle enjoyment, right? Like I said, no matter how you may feel on the gear coverage perspective, that is an individual choice that everybody gets to make, and there really shouldn't be any judgment for it, okay? If someone wants to squid, let them squid. But to overly imply that women specifically are attempting to ensnare the golden eye of every man that we're passing or whizzing by at fucking 70 and 80 miles an hour as if that's gonna do something for us, that's stupid and insulting and disrespectful and deserved a video. And I haven't seen a video done on the summer women's subject on YouTube. So now we've had the discussion. Leave us alone. Leave us alone. We gonna wear shorts if we want to. There's nothing you can do about it. T-shirt if we want to. It's not for you. If my cleavage is out, it's because I'm avoiding driving a freaking battleship through boob sweat. That's it. That's all. All right? I find it very ironic that I have literally ridden my motorcycle in a Cinderella dress and an extremely thin Power Rangers costume, and nobody accused me of overtly being sexy when I rode those. The only time us women get the sexual accusations is when we wear a fucking tank top. Is that your own personal security? Like, people that do that, like women that do that, is that your own personal security? Like, she just looks too sexy on a bike and it pisses you off? That's giving me insecurity, because if you truly cared about women's habits and clothing choices, you would have something to say about all the nonsense that we wear on our bikes, because I am an avid costumer on my motorcycle and nobody ever says anything about that other than the fact that I look fucking cool. I'm just saying, I'm getting little whiffs of jealousy here and there. Insecurity, babe, handle it. And for complete transparency, I would like everyone to know, the only time I or my girlfriends are actively seeking male attention whilst on bikes is during street vibrations in Reno, Nevada. And to be totally honest, we don't even want your attention. We just want your Mardi Gras beads. In the comments section below, let me know what you think about this subject. Ladies, have you been chastised before on your clothing choices during the summer months? And how did you feel about it? Like, how did you feel when just people just brought it up for no reason, as if you're just attention seeking? Men, have you been guilty of this? Please tell me you haven't been. Please, like, don't. Just don't, okay? But put your comments in the comments section below. Let us know what you think. Check out the first channel if you would so like to, or stick around on this channel. There will be more videos, sit down videos, motorcycle videos, more content, blogs, all that stuff. You know, both channels are active and I would love to see you here again. Hi, once again, my IRL friends. What up? When's the next ride? Call me. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, and I will see all you rowdy riders later. Bye.